matzo ball soup. So I have zucchini, I have sweet potatoes, parsnips, and we're going to add that in last.
Okay, add that in last. That's
so helpful. In real life, this would have been boiling for a long time, okay. Right? We've separated the meat, we're going to throw that in, we're going to add our veggies.
Berkshire, I'm going to give you a tip when it comes to making your stock. You can make it in a slow cooker / crock pot, and it's really lovely.
And that would save me a lot of time.
We're saving a lot of time.
Okay,
so tell us a little bit about your show. It's called Breaking Bread with Brooke Burke.
Yes, say that, but we have to do a challenge. Say that one 5 times fast. I know, it's a drinking game. I'm so happy that I got a chance to make the show because it's very sweet. It's one of those sort of cozy shows, which you don't hear about descriptive work very often. But it's about meaningful meals, it's about how we hit the pause button, how we connect through food. I grew up with a 5 o'clock family dinner every night.
Yes,
my father was not a great cook, but it was mandatory, and that's where we met. That's where we talked. That's where we caught up. My mom worked. My dad was at home. It wasn't great food, but we like counted on that experience. So this show, instead of just doing another celebrity interview or a straight up cooking show, because I wouldn't take on that responsibility, I decided to take up the guests on a walk down memory lane through the palate, bring up all kinds of sense memory, and take them back to a special place.
Nice. So
also, something
that came
up.
So you had Carney Wilson on.
Mark Burnett and Roma Downey came over to my house for the holidays.
Well,
we had a Christmas special.
Yeah,
right. Like, what do you cook for them? So Roma and I actually did a roasted chicken and root vegetables, and then we served my husband David and Mark out in the garden. It was really, really sweet.
How's that handsome husband of yours doing?
Oh, he's good.
Yeah,
he's good.
Too?
He's actually in town with my son. He does. He's got skills in the kitchen. He's very sexy. Men, very sexy to be able to mix it up in the kitchen. Yeah.
Awesome.
He's really good.
All right, so let's let this keep cooking.
Okay.
Tell us about the matzo balls, because
that
you like them a little bit smaller than some matzo balls.
We know at home we like to make them actually a little bit larger. But,
oh, we
but,
did it wrong.
But it's okay. No, there's no right or wrong with cooking. There really isn't. I mean, you have to be willing to like screw it all up and throw it away. And sometimes with matzo balls,
true,
you have to do that. Because
yeah,
sometimes you'll make matzo balls and they won't be fluffy and soft.
Right.
So you can make them any size.
Do you have a method for keeping them soft?
I actually throw a little bit of soda water in my water that I boil them in, which is a little tip trick.
Oh.
And I don't know why. But I get the store-bought matzo ball mix.
Okay.
I follow the instructions on the box.
And perfect. That's basically what a couple of
yeah,
things.
So we're going to beat those eggs. You're going to throw in your vegetable oil.
All right.
You're going to add that in there. You can use a fork. You can use a spatula. You must let it chill in the refrigerator for 15 minutes.
Oh, okay.
So don't miss that step or you're going to have problems.
All
right. So mix this up. We throw it in the refrigerator. One of the things that I love about this dish is I love to do it with my kids. It's so interactive. They love to roll
it's
up the matzo ball.
Right?
It's the best. My older kids come home, thank you, they come home from school, the house smells like love. You have to wet your hands,
yeah,
so the matzo ball doesn't stick to your hands. So you wet your hands,
okay,
you roll up the balls,
and
we've already done that.
Those.